congratulations on capably leading such a brilliant show for all these years.
Thank you so much.
I cannot sing the Expanse's praises enough, but the Rocinante crew is kind of the heart of the show, and this season you're a little bit separated from your heart. So what new sides of Holden will we see in this new environment?
Yeah, it's a different structure this year. And, you know, having been a fan of the books, it obviously revolves around book five. It was an interesting experience having Holden on a more lonely journey this year. I think there's an irony as well. He is the most comfortable he's ever been with the responsibilities that have been given to him as a leader. But the personal, interpersonal part of his life has the rug pulled out from under it from the very beginning. So, you know, he's confident and capable of dealing with what he has to deal with this year. But it's hard because the family side of this story, he worries about them and misses them and wants to get back to them. And, you know, so much transpires after they separate. And to be apart from your family in those kind of circumstances is very difficult. So, you know, there's the twin storylines of Holden going after the protomolecule and the ramifications of what that has brought. And then there's also the trying to get back to the family storyline. And both are equally as important, you know, to Holden in different ways.
Definitely. Speaking of the protomolecule, this is kind of the first post-Miller Holden that we're seeing in a bit. Are there lingering effects from that connection? Like, what's the new Holden like?
You know, I think, yeah, he's the only one left, really, now that that Miller's gone in totality, concerned about what he knows is within those ring gates. He understands the danger to the entire species. For what is present there and how dangerous that is. I think if anything, the effect is through the evolution of Holden continuously becoming more and more confident in his responsibilities. This is a man who has been through a lot. He has connected circuits that has shown him the beginnings and ends of civilizations. He's seen genocides. He's had family betrayals. I mean, he's been, you know, through a lot. So he's, you know, there's not much that shakes Holden at this point. He's firmly got his feet on the ground. But I will say that everything that has led up to this point, you know, Holden's always had an ethical core to him, and that's always been his anchor. But his capability has leveled up to where that ethical core was.
And, definitely.
And, you know, he's... I think his experiences with Miller and everything else that has come before that, even through the stumbles and failures and ugly moments that Holden has had, being overwhelmed and afraid, I think he's found his strength through his humility and just truly understanding just how small he is, even though he knows how important the connection that he has is to the protomolecule, but just has a much more macro picture and is constantly trying to convince people to see it instead of fighting with each other. So that's where.
Well, hopefully they can all come together with him.
Hopefully.
Thank you so much. Yeah. I can't wait for everyone to see season five.
Oh, thanks so much. Thank you.
Have a great day.
You too.